After years of news, sometimes we get tired of our now used and well-served monitor. So what do you do with such a monitor? Throw it out? Give it to somebody else? Recycle it like some goody two-shoes? No, we're gonna turn it into a bootleg TV. Let's get started. First, I want to say this project does require a little bit of monetary investment, aka big money. Though, just a little bit so we can transition our monitor into a TV hood. Second, you need a monitor with a headphone jack and either a DisplayPort or HDMI port. But why though? Because most monitors either don't have speakers built in at all or have really terrible ones. Guess what TVs have? Speakers.
That's why if you don't want to use the underwater radio speakers that your monitor has, you have to get a soundbar.
But Jimmy, why do you suggest a soundbar instead of something like a Bluetooth speaker or bookshelf style speakers? You got me. Just kidding. The reason for this is because it's much more difficult to change volume on a Bluetooth style or bookshelf style speaker. You physically have to walk up to the speaker, press a couple buttons, or dial a knob back and forth to change volume. But with the soundbar, you usually get a remote to change volume. You know, like a TV. The thing we're trying to emulate. So if you're going with the soundbar route, make sure your soundbar has a remote and a headphone jack so you can connect it to your monitor. Then you just have to connect everything together. Kind of like brain surgery, except we can actually do this. Connect headphone jack to headphone jack and bam, we're done, right? No, we had to plug different devices into the TV. But as you plug input devices into the TV, you might not have the right cable or not enough inputs for the TV. If you need more ports for your inputs like gaming consoles, DirecTV, or Chromecast, then I recommend you get an HDMI switcher. It only takes up one HDMI slot and allows you to switch between different inputs. And this one also comes with a nice little remote. If you have a DisplayPort on your monitor, you can get an HDMI to DisplayPort cable and connect that to the switcher, and bam, you now have a new to you TV. So you got everything connected and you just need some cable management done. But why would anyone do all of this in the first place? Well, it's a waste to throw away perfectly useful electronics, and not everyone has the patience and DIY know-how to build something like a smart mirror and using your old monitor. So this is something that's easy to do and could provide a new small TV for, you know, your kid's bedroom or a workout room or something. The only downside to this bootleg TV is that it will lack some TV features like antenna support, the initial input selection, and showing volume on the display. But with the basic cheap soundbar, our bootleg TV already sounds much better than most TVs that don't have soundbars. And when you do decide to get rid of the monitor, you can then use a soundbar on a different TV that you own. The only downside I can see to this entire bootleg TV project is the fact that monitors are typically smaller than your average TV, which means this sort of TV wouldn't work in a place like a living room. It looked like a TV for Oompa Loompas. So I think this setup is great for people who are trying to save a buck or recycle their old electronics. Just be mindful that this thing's not gonna be an ultra 4K OLED, QLED, HDR, 3D, Alexa enabled, featuring Dante from the Devil May Cry series and 5G network capability TV. It does, however, make a nice budget TV alternative, and that's great for a recycled product. Anyway, guys, let me ask you a question. Would you do something like this? Is this worthy of doing, or would you just toss away your old monitor? Would you try doing this yourself? Leave that all down in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and well, don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.